Were you aware you're watching the compilation video of 50 episodes of the comedy short series, Were You Aware?
All compiled here for you, the goofy, zany, silly, ridiculous comedy show that I put together over the last 2 years.
Well, if you weren't aware, I'll slap myself. Oh, you weren't?
Can't believe I've written 50 of these ridiculous things, but here they are, and I'm gonna make a lot more. Okay! That's great! Watch every one of them. I just fell in a crawdad hole.
Featuring a cast of hundreds, these are the goofy imaginings that I have on a day-to-day, and I bring them to you so that you are successfully distracted from this messed up world.
Okay, just welcome to the compilation. 50 episodes. That was a bad idea.
You can watch them now. Enjoy.
Were you aware that Mario was not super at all when his mother died after falling off a very steep cliff with jagged spiked rocks at its base? No? Oh yeah, well never mind, none of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time. Were you aware that Foghorn Leghorn was eventually murdered by an actual chicken hawk with a horn in the fog beneath an eerie October sky? No? Oh yeah, well never mind, none of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time. Were you aware that at the end of Return of the Jedi, after Vader's corpse roasts, the Ewoks dined on Anakin's charred meat? It sent Luke into an existential quandary that left him making decisions in life that led to this? No? Yeah, well, never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time. Were you aware that in the film Lion King, most of the wildebeests in this scene eventually died? In a later novelization, The Chronicles of Simba, Simba tracks all of the beasts and murders them. He revels in their demise, for in his mind, they were responsible for his father Mufasa's death. Simba would gradually kill every wildebeest on the continent of Africa in his quest for revenge. No? Oh yeah, well never mind, none of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time. Were you aware that the tornado in the film Twister was a direct descendant of the Twister scene in The Wizard of Oz, but merely a cousin of the behemoth Twister scene in The Day After Tomorrow? No? Oh yeah? Well never mind, none of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time. Were you aware that Harry Potter star Daniel Radcliffe developed an incredible skill while trapped in the Dursley Stairway Closet? In his seclusion underneath the stairs on set, Daniel grew fond of singing and soon became known on the set for his unique vocal range. Later, David Bowie was quoted as saying, "I listen to Daniel every day during my morning chili consumption routine." No? Oh yeah, well never mind, none of that happened at all. Just deliberately wasting your time. Were you aware that after Gandalf the White traveled with Frodo to the undying lands of Valinor, he was reverted back to Gandalf the Grey and forced to watch movie trailers and fight crime? No?
Oh, yeah, well, never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time. Gollum.
Were you aware that after the events of The Dark Knight, the Joker was fully and completely rehabilitated at Gotham Asylum? He went on to become a mascot for a hamburger sandwich restaurant chain. No?
Oh, yeah, well, never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware that Link's tragic experience that left his uncle dead in A Link to the Past was only the beginning of that story arc? Later on, comic book writer and artist Stan Lee stole Link's true story about his uncle and eventually cashed in on the whole deal, which sent Link into a delusion which overlapped time and space. No?
Oh yeah, well never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware Master Chief also had intense training as a culinary artist before the events of the Fall of Reach? The Chief learned a very specific way of sautéing salted meats that would later benefit his seclusion on the many halos found in Covenant-occupied space. Grunt stir-fry prepared by the Master Chef? Anyone?
No! Oh yeah, well, never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa!
Were you aware that underwear is what you wear down there, for after sitting in an uncushioned chair, an inventor thought it fair to cover mankind's collective derriere? Later he was attacked by a bear whose name was Claire. Do you care? No. Oh yeah, never mind, none of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time. Were you aware that Captain Crunch was eventually demoted to Lieutenant Commander? Not long afterwards, he went rogue and became a vicious pirate notorious for torturing his captives by slowly cutting the entire roof of their mouths with a jagged blade.
No? Oh yeah, well never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware that in the original Dune, Sting was nearly replaced by the actor Martin Short? David Lynch thought Martin would add some more strangeness to the big-budget atmospheric art film. When word got back to Sting about the recasting, Sting whipped out his mutant tail and stung the director with his sharp, bejeweled stinger. Lynch was very upset by this encounter and screamed regularly without provocation for many years. Sting went on to dream of rain. No?
Oh yeah, well, never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware that scientists engineered a cat to talk with human-like vocal cords? After the difficult procedure, they spent weeks attempting to teach the feline how to sound out words. Just when the scientists were reaching for the syringe to euthanize the specimen, the cat fell off of the podium it was perched on and hit his head on the way down. The cat then pawed its head, shuddering in pain, and uttered his first expression in perfect English. Meow. No?
Oh yeah, well never mind! None of that happened at all! I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware that baseball was originally going to be called Hot Dog Genocide? The first players of the now famous game used to hit the balls being pitched at them with dogs that had recently overheated and gone comatose. At first, the seemingly violent acts were thought of as a possible trigger to awaken the slumbering canines. Then those involved kept on doing it out of the bizarre, twisted pleasure of it all. So naturally, it became America's favorite pastime. No? Oh yeah, well never mind, none of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time. Play ball! Were you aware that Samus's original storyline had her chasing a man named Anthony, who like her also adorns a metal suit? Tony was from the Earth Realm, also called Midgard, and he was known for his engineering skills, being a playboy, and Samus was going to get the story she wanted from this man one way or another. Wait, no? Oh, yeah. Well, never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time. Were you aware Santa Claus is in fact real? He lives in the north just past the Canadian shoreline and goes by the name Timothy Sheldon Abernathy. He builds toys, too, but he usually fashions them out of rusty barbed wire, cotton, and sugarcane. He often gardens with his freakish gnomes as he looks upon his tilling tools and joyfully points and laughs while yelling, ho, ho, ho. No? Oh yeah, well, never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time. Were you aware the Star Wars Holiday Special was so devastating to a young Marxist in New Jersey that he began a hate group that inspired a legendary martial artist who won a fight in a tournament that led Rick Astley to begin his music career, thus stimulating a worldwide clickbait phenomenon that randomly enrages the human population so much so that it is literally the cause of most of the world's problems? No? Oh yeah, well never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time. Were you aware that in the film Back to the Future, Marty McFly took a leak in the woods near Old Man Peabody's pine tree farm? The urine was later smelled by a dog who was supposed to be hit by a truck later that day, but because of the few seconds he was smelling Marty's transdimensional waste, he missed his fate with death, only to later be bludgeoned to death by an angry Biff Tannen after his second dousing in manure later on in the timeline. No? Oh yeah, well never mind, none of that happened at all.
I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware Rocky IV influenced a man to kill himself? An actual fighter named Drago, after leaving the premiere of Rocky IV, went home and decided to kill himself by swallowing a frisbee, because he would never live up to the fictional character who carried his name. So he thought, well, at least I will be known as the guy who killed himself with a frisbee. No?
Yeah, well, never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware that the Wolverine, played by Hugh Jackman, was originally going to be played by an obscure actor named Contrast Jillwoman? Unlike Jackman, who was known for his excellent theater performances in musicals and dramas, Jillwoman was known for his street screaming, cross-dressing, and random projectile vomiting. No?
Oh yeah, well never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware that in Fortnite, the Battle Royale play option began with a monarchical figure starting a thumb war with his multiple reptilian children, nieces, nephews, and other blood relatives? Which actually took 5 score and a fortnight to get back in time to understand how to escape the Matrix within the program that ultimately led to a dance-off which altered actual human history. No?
Oh, yeah, well, never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware that SpongeBob SquarePants is played by the highly respected actor Sir Herbert Beerbohm Tree, who after being successfully cloned in 1998 was immediately forced into voice acting by his handlers? Beerbohm, oddly enough, has an insatiable appetite for starfish and crab. No?
Oh yeah, well, never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware that Tom Holland and Zendaya could have been in one of the many sequels to Home Alone? In the early 2000s, Tom and Zendaya were adorable kids with a passion for acting. At a fateful audition, the two locked eyes and were seemingly drawn to one another so much that an aura could be seen around them. Suddenly, Tom grabbed a spider and threw it on the casting director, who screamed loudly, "Not a Spider-Man! No way Home Alone will cast these two!" No? Oh yeah, well, never mind. None of that happened at all. I just...
Were you aware Bill Murray once pranked an actual ghost? Back in the mid-80s in the town of Punxsutawney, Pennsylvania, Bill was talking to a shrink about his anxiety when he witnessed an orange tabby cat steal some lasagna as the shrink lost the translation of Bill's testimony. He then suffered a stroke and his corporeal form immediately began haunting the office. Bill snuck up behind the ghost and pulled the chair out from underneath him. The ghost doctor then bellowed, "Who you gonna call for help now, Bill?" Mr. Murray then set to the high seas on a grand adventure. No?
None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware that Amber Heard and Johnny Depp were meant to be together? Amber was walking down the road one day while Johnny was eating some nachos on the same road. Johnny was using the nachos like a spoon, eagerly dipping each one into the cheese, when suddenly Amber tripped and fell right into Mr. Depp's arms. She looked up into his eyes and calmly cooed, "I would love some of that Depp." Johnny then replied, "Excuse me, did you say you want some of this dip, or were you referring to the cheese dip?" Amber said, "Dip, I want some dip." Johnny said, "Well, I wish that is what I heard, Miss Heard." They then gave true love's first kiss. No?
Oh yeah, well never mind, mate. Well, that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time. Savvy?
Were you aware Jim Carrey bit a fan immediately after taking a selfie? He bit the young man in the face and
as soon as the flash from the camera brightened reality, it sent Jim into a mad rage.
The fan fled as an animal aura formed around Jim, and flocks of creatures descended upon the actor, causing a panic before Jim finally calmed down and decided to take up painting. No?
Oh yeah? Well, never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware of the cocaine bear, whose hair was a golden brown so fair? He walked along the lake he loved, and met a trainer well known of. A show business bear he then became, but shame and sadness came with the fame. He ran into a man on the movie set who said, "Hey friend, I gotcha, no sweat." Out came a bag filled with white powder. The bear was hooked within the hour. The nose candy soon fried his brain, for the bear was now hooked on the cocaine. Yes, Cocaine Bear is now a biopic movie. The story is tragic, but the film looks groovy. Would you believe this is a true story? Or maybe you left because you're boring? No? Oh yeah, well never mind, none of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware Walt Disney hated theme parks? When Walt was just a lad, his mother left him alone in a forest-themed park, where he met a witch named Angela. She pricked his finger as he marveled at her beauty. It is said that he was then transported to a galaxy far, far away, where he met a shaggy dog that convinced him mice were perverted. As he was projected back to the Earth realm, he witnessed a hunter shoot his mother dead. Just then, a young Kurt Russell whispered into his ear, "It's a small world after all," which inspired Disney to work hand in hand with anti-Semites. No.
Well, never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware Avatar was inspired by James Cameron's life experiences? James was on a long hike in the jungles of New Guinea when he discovered a village of tiny blue humanoids. They lived inside strange fungoid structures and loved to sing. After creepily observing them from the shadows, Cameron used his sorcery to destroy the fungoid village, and with his trusty feline by his side, they devoured the Smurfs after boiling them. Then Mr. Cameron had an epiphany. What if I made a movie about giant blue people who are invaded and devoured by a corporate entity? So Avatar was then conceived, and Cameron sang to himself, "La la, la 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 la, la 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 la." No?
Oh yeah, well never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware that Kanye West was related to Adolf Hitler? Kanye Omari West was born in the 70s. At some point, he met a crazy old brown doctor, whom he dubbed Dr. Brown. Brown allowed Ye to drive his car, and unfortunately, the vehicle, after reaching 88 miles per hour, traveled back to the late 1800s Austria. Ye soon met a young woman named Clara Paulsel. They fell in love and quickly had several children. While attempting to repair Brown's car one day, the capacitor exploded, sending Ye back into the 1980s, where he then began writing rap and hip-hop music. Clara then married her high school sweetheart, Aloy Hitler, who gave the children she had with Ye his name. After all, he was raising them. So in the end, Kanye West is in reality the father of Adolf Hitler. No?
Oh yeah, well, never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware Indiana Jones inspired Harrison Ford to become an archaeologist? Harrison thought, hey, this guy gets the ladies, so maybe I can too. Harrison jumped from girl to girl and finally learned to fly, just as Indiana Jones did. Then, Harrison fell in love with digging and for a short time took on the job of a ghoul for Montana University. After a while, he went back to acting and presented to the world his magnum opus, Hollywood Homicide. Unfortunately, most fans and critics hated the film, which in turn inspired many individuals to move to Hollywood to in fact commit murder. That is, homicide. No?
Oh yeah? Well, never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware Conan O'Brien was abandoned in the wilderness of Mongolia? On a much-needed vacation, the O'Briens took to the lush boreal forest near the Siberian border. While being chased by a bear, 4-year-old Conan O'Brien was lost and thought to be dead as the other 5 siblings were rushed away from the forest by the O'Brien family. Conan found himself alone and hungry, but luckily, he met an ancient Mongolian warrior who was indeed descended from the bloodline of Genghis Khan. The hermit took Conan under his wing and taught him the ways of barbarism, joke-telling, and comedic writing. So for a time, before returning to the United States on the back of a great Mongolian condor, he was Conan the Barbarian. No?
Oh yeah, well, never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware Tucker Carlson once hated any news at all and also wild dogs? As a young boy, Tucker was often forced to shovel the snow off the family driveway every morning, and just at dawn on each day, the paperboy would hurl the written news as hard as he could at Tucker, often hitting him in the head with the paper. In the evenings, his father would tape his eyes open and force him to watch Walter Cronkite's reports. Tucker rebelled and eventually took to the local woods for refuge. In his isolation, he was attacked multiple times by a fox ad nauseum. After years of rehabilitation and Tucker's father implementing various MKUltra techniques, Tucker Carlson then dedicated his life to journalism. He still feels the bite of the fox at his heels anytime he reads the news to this day. No?
Oh, yeah, well, never mind. None of that happened at all.
I just deliberately wasted your time. Were you aware Madonna once tried to have Weird Al Yankovic shaved? Yes, Madonna, in a fit of jealous rage, hired a man to shave Weird Al's famous mustache. Al was able to trick the man into believing his mustache was responsible for ending the Cold War, and soon the once hit man for hire dedicated his life to shaving ice rather than murdering people for a living. Way to go, Al. No?
Oh yeah, well, never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware Joe Pesci cut another album based on the film Goodfellas? Joe had been a crooner for years, and as soon as the mob film was a wrap, he collaborated with Scorsese to produce such great pop hits as Oh No, Prison Pasta, Oh So Many Trunk Stabs, I Amuse You How, Don't Look at That Guy, I'll Kill Ya. The album was a deadly scandal entitled Little Joe Sure Can Sing and Hemorrhage. No?
Oh yeah, well, never mind. Well, none of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware Ghostface from Scream wrote poetry? He would take to the pen in the limbs of an old tree. He would put rhymes together using the inked feather. The words brought to light the dark thoughts in his sight. Here is a bit from the words that were writ. I stab you, I knife you, I gut you like a fish. I kill you, I steal you, it's death for you, I wish. Will you catch me? Will you stop me? Can you quench the thirst inside? Am I a suspect? Am I Stu? Could it be Billy too? Are you Sydney? Can I scare you? The blood spilled could free me. The sweet release, your doom is nigh, crimes they can't police. Soon after the writing, you'll surely be dying. Then Ghostface went crazy, he felt rather lazy. He then went home and watched Driving Miss Daisy. No?
Oh yeah, well, never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware Baby Yoda, aka Grogu, was nearly expelled from the Jedi Order? Not long before the Purge and Order 66, Grogu could be found chillaxing in the Jedi Archive Library, curiously streaming episodes of The Muppets, Sesame Street, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Frog and Toad, and Futurama on the Holodeck. Grogu would also play Frogger and Battletoads in excess as he chewed on a Kermit the Frog doll. The Jedi librarian, Jocasta Nu, was about to expose Grogu's laziness and wretched eating habits, but Anakin Skywalker put a lightsaber through those plans. No?
Oh yeah, well never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware Scorpion in the original Mortal Kombat had a different catchphrase? In the original version of Mortal Kombat, they attempted to make the classic arcade fighter into more of a friendly game of gotchas, rather than the bloody bone cracker it became. And so, Scorpion's catchphrase, "Get over here," was originally,
"I prefer you here next to me!"
No. Oh yeah, well never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware Casper is a black ghost in the new Disney and Netflix-produced movie? Disney and Netflix have done it again and are bringing the fans exactly what they say the fans want. A friendly ghost with a new look and feel. Casper used to be haunting the closet, but now he is coming out in the new film called Black Gay Casper. He is transparent.
No. Oh yeah, well, never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware Donald J. Trump is the greatest criminal mastermind of our time? When Trump was just a lad, he took lessons from ninjas, Shaolin monks, and even a secret society of forest rangers who learned the ways of the wild. As he grew in his billions in the mid-80s, Trump started taking out gangsters, bankers, and various random mafioso with his own personal assault squad. He was labeled a terrorist and soon ran and won the US presidency, just as he was about to wipe out all minorities, but especially transgender aborigines and the cast of The View. Trump was arrested and a new era of peace began for mankind. No?
Oh yeah, well, never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware Arnold Schwarzenegger bathed an alligator? Arnie had been depressed after years of bullying from Maria and willfully ignoring housemaids, so he decided to clean up his act and go on a covert mission to heal himself. He then naturally fell in love with an alligator named Alyssa, who got herself kidnapped by some terrorists. Arnold fought his way through the villains and eventually found himself dangerously close to Alyssa during a routine water dousing. The bath was almost over when Arnold relapsed and his depression pulled the trigger.
No? Oh yeah, well never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware Sean Connery once cut an album after his well-renowned performance in Darby O'Gill and the Little People? Sean's singing voice was a marvel.
She is my dear, my darling one, my smiling and big island one.
The album had such smash hits as Shaking You and I'm Not Stirred, The Hunt for the Red Handprint on Her Face, The Untouchable Male Emotions, James Won't Bond with Her, The Rock I Threw at Her, Robin Slaps Marion, and so much more. The album didn't offend even one man, but a whole bunch of women were upset, and it caused quite a stir due to its title. Sean Connery sings the Black and Blues, Justified Open-Handed Slap. No?
Oh yeah, well never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware Kevin Costner once inspired Jimmy Kimmel after a strange run-in with a Karen? Kevin was eating breakfast at a diner not long before shooting The Untouchables. As he sipped his orange juice, a woman approached him and asked for an autograph. He obliged, and she then offered to pay for his meal. Confused, Kevin asked the waiter to give him the check. He told the waiter, whose name was Jimmy, what the woman wanted. The waiter then looked at Kevin dead in the eye and said, "Wow, that sure is going to cost her, Mr. Costner." Wait, so that's how you got your name, sir? Thus, the comedy career of Jimmy Kimmel began. Naturally, Kevin unmercifully beat Mr. Kimmel after the exchange. No?
Oh, yeah, well, never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware Natalie Portman's soon-to-be ex-husband once traded a diamond for a TV remote control at a pawn shop?
Before Natalie was cheated on by this complete idiot, doofus, moron, numbskull, two-timing jerkface imbecile, and obviously mentally ill fool, he once chose to eat a pack of Smarties rather than a filet mignon cooked by Gordon Ramsay. He also once swapped his Porsche for a rusted one-wheeled bicycle. Eventually, he made his way to a pawn shop and traded a perfectly cut diamond for a $5 remote control. There was also a time, before he cheated on the utterly gorgeous Natalie, where he turned down a free trip and full paid tour of the entire country of New Zealand, only to go to a bar in New Jersey instead. Maybe Natalie should have looked into this brainless, worthless, walking meat sack's background before getting hitched. No?
Oh yeah, well, never mind. None of it happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware that Joe Rogan was once known as Beefman McToeface? During a mediocre stand-up routine back in the late 90s, Joe was witnessed by a crowd to have morphed into a beef toe that swore a lot and spouted CIA-directed conspiracy theories. As the crowd began to vomit, one man yelled loudly, "Hey, that's Beefman McToeface!" To which Joe replied, "I know." No? Oh yeah, well never mind, none of that happened at all, I just deliberately wasted your time. Were you aware Dick Van Dyke had an alternative universe experience on the set of Mary Poppins? It took place in this scene.
Oh yeah, well, never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware Mr. T once had a friend named Fool? When Mr. T was about 9 years old, he met Fool Johnson at a summer camp and they became fast friends. Fool would often take drugs, alcohol, and bully just about everyone around him, other than Mr. T, who he adored and even pitied due to his infatuation with a warm, sugary blackleaf brew. After a time, everyone that knew Mr. T began to pity his friendship with Fool, who was clearly a phony baloney. After a counselor contacted Mr. T's mother, she arrived at the camp and confronted Mr. T about Fool, and she told him that everyone was worried about him. Mr. T ran towards the camp lake and found Fool about to jump into the deep with heavy bricks roped to his legs. He looked at Mr. T and said, "I've let you down, T-man. Don't let kids be like me. They shouldn't worry about you for being my friend. They should pity the fool, Mr. Black T, my brother." And with that, he jumped in the lake and drowned. From that day on, the boy now dubbed Mr. T developed Tourette's and consistently said the words, "I pity the fool." No?
Oh yeah, well never mind. None of that happened at all. I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware Garth Brooks used to be a girl named Geraldine? When Garth was just a little girl, he would often play in the mud and bring frogs and snakes home to his fearful and cowardly mother. One day, Geraldine's mother, Colleen, witnessed her little girl pretend to be a firefighter after having watched a performance by the village people. So naturally, she then sent Geraldine to a doctor's office in Mexico, where they butchered Geraldine and changed her into Garth, who grew up to be the country singing legend we know today. No?
Oh yeah, well never mind, none of that happened at all, I just deliberately wasted your time.
Were you aware the M on Mario's hat actually stands for Marvin? Because when Mario was young, his father would often play Marvin Gaye music for the young turtle stomper. He played it so much that Mario eventually slew his father in a fit of rage, and then he started climbing down sewage pipes in order to cope with the filth he had become. Later, he just wore the hat as a reminder. No?
Oh yeah, well never mind, none of that happened at all, I just deliberately wasted your time.